It's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to be talking about all kinds of malocclusions. Yay, malocclusions. This is going to be really both a doctor-facing and a consumer-facing video. I just want to educate you on malocclusions, what's out there, what should be fixed, what is most important to be fixed. This is going to be kind of a long video, so I'm super excited just to put it all together with some props and everything and to tell you more. Hang on real quick. Let me get my props. All right, this is my malocclusion poster. So you can see at the top, we've got normal bite. So normal bite should be, if you've watched my other videos, when you bite down, your top teeth should be right in front of your bottom teeth without really any major space between your bottom and your top teeth. And they should hang down and overlap your bottom teeth a little bit. So you can see when you bite down, you see most of your bottom teeth, but not all your bottom teeth. They should overlap by about 10 to 30 to 40%. That's normal, okay? Now let's go to abnormal. So let's go ahead and start with vertical. So vertical is one plane of space problem, okay? So for vertical, we have two different things. See this here? This is deep bite. Deep bite is when you bite down and you cannot see your bottom teeth at all or mostly. Maybe you see only 10, 20, 30% of your bottom teeth as opposed to, you know, 70, 80, 90% of your bottom teeth. This is a problem. So let's talk a little bit more about deep bite and its opposite, which is open bite. See that there? That's where you bite down and the top and bottom teeth don't overlap at all. All right, let's talk a little bit more about deep bite, open bite, and vertical problems. So big problems must be treated. And as soon as you see them, you want to start treating them. So if you see them in a 3, 4, 5-year-old, you can already start doing things. It's not going to get better, it's only going to get worse. So definitely something that must be treated. Let's talk about deep bites first. So again, deep bites like this, when you bite down, when you don't see the bottom teeth, over time, deep bites will always get worse. You'll start hitting the roof of your mouth, you'll start damaging the gum and likely loosening your top front teeth, and possibly they will fall out. That is basically the sequelae over a period of time. I was a deep bite patient. It's one of those things I tell my personal story just because I want dentists to understand and I want parents to understand why you want to treat a deep bite. So exactly what I said happened to me. So basically I had a deep bite, nice teeth, you know, a little bit of spacing and stuff, but big deep bite. And I guess my pediatric dentist didn't understand what a deep bite was and what the problem was because he kept saying my teeth were fine, even though I knew they weren't fine because when I was a kid, I was biting up on the roof of my mouth. So over time, I had traumatic occlusion, front teeth got loose, roots got damaged, front teeth were wiggly. So had to get treatment, right? Or I would have lost all these teeth in high school. So did get them fixed, but they are still permanently damaged. So I can't like bite into an apple. I can't bite into a bagel. I'll lose my front teeth if I do that. So that's why you have to get it fixed. It changes the way of your life, you know, permanently. So must correct deep bites when you see them in kids. As soon as you see them, start fixing them. It won't get better. Open bites are generally the opposite. So those can be genetic. Deep bites can also be genetic. Open bites can be genetic. It can be a result of your jaw growing down more than forward. In addition, it can be related to oral habits, malfunctional problems, problems with airway, problems with tonsils, adenoids, soft diet, thumb sucking, finger sucking, tongue thrusting. Those all cause open bites. And it must be treated. It will always get worse. And these can have, you know, whereas deep bites maybe causes problems with loss of teeth, right? And maybe some speech issues with deep bites, lisping. Open bites are very, very, very bad for your overall total body health. Because in time, your tongue will have to learn to adapt a different way in order to speak properly and to breathe properly and to swallow properly. And that incorrect placement of the tongue will actually diminish your sleep at nighttime because you do swallow at night. So, and that will actually lead to more systemic and actual physical body problems related to sleep, your brain, how you feel, how you act. It's huge. And I've seen it happening. There's a lot of studies that support this. So malocclusion is something that's no joke. Open bites must be fixed. So really, really important. And I know speech and language pathologists also believe in that. Malfunctional therapists also believe in that. And more dentists are understanding the correlation between airway and open bites and speech. So please, 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 if you see someone with an open bite, go get it treated. Really, really important. In addition, you can't just do aligners or braces to fix that because if you do not fix the bad habit that's behind the open bite, it will just continue to come back even if you're in a retainer. So it's much more than just orthodontics. So if you have an open bite and they're just doing braces to fix it, you probably want to ask about what else you need, because your doctor may not be aware of that. All right, let's move on to the next plane of space, which is transverse. Okay, so transverse is also known as crossbite, and that's where the back teeth of one of your arches is either more in or more out than the other one. So let me go ahead and show you how to type it out real quick. Okay, so you can see here on the back teeth that the top back teeth are supposed to be a little bit wider than the bottom back teeth, and it's kind of shown here, right? Can you see that? They should be out by a few millimeters more. And the cusps of the top teeth, the lingual or palatal cusp, the inside cusps, this, 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 and this, should fit right in that groove of the bottom teeth. It should go right down there. So if I checked with articulating paper, you would see it right there when they bit down, okay? That is a proper transverse. But not everyone's like that. Some people have one side in, some people have both sides in, some people have one side out. So we need to get that to fit together. If it's not fitting together properly, then your teeth will be at different angles. They won't be functioning properly. It can cause damage to your teeth, fractures of your teeth, problems with your jaw joints. So it is, as well as just general crowding and bite problems, discomfort, difficulty eating, speaking, and chewing. So it is something you want to correct. It is much, much easier to correct this while a child is still growing. You could start working on it as young as 3, 4, 5, 6 in early interceptive treatment. Really easy with some gentle appliances that can just be worn at nighttime. Or you can do it with braces and aligners as they get older, but it's highly recommended you do this before they finish puberty. So it is really important to go ahead and get started. Remember, puberty can happen at all different ages, and girls can start, you can finish as young as age 8. So, and sometimes you only have a few teeth in, so parents and dentists aren't thinking that timing is like that, but it is. So it's really important to get the ball rolling with fixing transverse issues. I love the idea of doing expanders when a child's young. There's removable ones. You can color them. You can put glitter in them. You can put decals in them. You can have fun. You can also do it with aligners sometimes, depending on what the problem is. So it is something you want to go ahead and address as soon as possible. In addition, the great thing about fixing transverse problems is it can often help you with airway as well, help you breathe better, sleep better, and feel better. All right, let's go on to the next problem. Hang on. All right, so the next problem we're going to talk about is sagittal. So sagittal is another plane of space. Sagittal is basically front to back, okay? So somebody that has an underbite or an overjet is a sagittal. So see this here with the front teeth are more forward, the lower front teeth are more forward than the top. That is what some people call underbite, or we call that negative overjet. The opposite to that is your regular overjet, where the front teeth are more forward than the bottom teeth. Let's talk a little bit more about that. So in Caucasian populations, overjet is actually relatively common with the front teeth more forward than the bottom teeth. Not a huge problem. It won't get worse over time. You know, only thing can get worse is if you're thumb sucking and you're pushing them forward. But it won't get worse over time. It's usually related to a small lower jaw, but it can also be related to trauma or oral habits. Not so bad. You might have speech issues. Maybe your bite's not functioning together. But in the whole realm of issues that we're talking about, I would call that the most innocuous. It's the most harmless. Okay. Nobody's going to die from having 3 millimeters of overjet. Matter of fact, I have 3 millimeters of overjet, and I made a choice to do that. So it's fine, right? So obviously, if you're getting braces or aligners and that you've got a kid, you should make everything perfect for sure. But sometimes in adults, overjet isn't corrected, and that's totally fine. Ultimately, up to you. And in addition, if you're correcting overjet, sometimes it can flatten your profile. So let's go ahead and talk a little bit more about that. All right, again, I love being the demo person. So you can see profile is your profile, right? So there's something called as the aesthetic plane. And the aesthetic plane is if you drew a line from the tip of your nose to the tip of your chin, your lips should just be right behind it, you know? They shouldn't really be in front of it. I mean, created like decades ago. So I think now more than ever, actually having full lips is much more, you know, aesthetic for consumers. So what we don't want to do is we don't want to cave in a profile. We don't want, if someone has strong features, strong nose and chin, we don't want the lips to be too far back. So we don't want to do mechanics and orthodontics that can condition a profile, which is often what happens with a lot of orthodontics. If it's done, you know, with extractions or a lot of IPR or something like that. So just things to keep in mind when you're correcting overjet is you don't want to affect a profile. So sometimes it's not possible. So just many different things to keep in mind. So anyways, we talked about transverse, we talked about sagittal, and we talked about vertical problems today. And of course, we've got crowding and spacing as well. Those are pretty self-explanatory. So it's really important that you talk about these things with your dentist or orthodontist. If you have any other questions or you want to talk more about it, if you're a consumer, feel free to join our consumer-facing Facebook group, which is a great community where people who are either considering going through orthodontics or are already currently on the orthodontic journey can go ahead and join. And it's moderated by lots of really great dentists and orthodontists who are all USA licensed and handpicked. So it's just a community service that, you know, value statement that they help to support consumers as well with this Facebook group. If you'd like to join as a moderator, feel free to reach out to me directly. Dentists are only allowed to join if I've had an opportunity to check with, to talk to them first to make sure that they have the right values. So in any case, I'm excited to talk to you more. If you are a dentist that has any questions about orthodontics, we welcome for you to reach out to our team. You can reach us at StraightSmileSolutions.com/contact. That is only for dentists and people in the dental industry. If you are a consumer, unfortunately, we do not help consumers one-on-one. You'll want to go ahead and find a great dentist or orthodontist in your local area and connect with them. If you don't have one, we know many of them, and we'd be glad to refer you to one of our favorites. So you can still reach out to us, and we'll do our best to get you a referral, or join our Facebook group, and there's lots of great ones there, too. All right, thanks so much. We hope to talk to you more soon. Take care.